had a good day with the Lord on Yom Kippur, and it's officially over now in Singapore, but it's still continuing in Jerusalem for about 4 or 5 more hours, I think. So, again, it's a real privilege to be with you on this holy day. And as always, we carry Israel on our hearts, in our hearts. Here for Israel.
Thank you. prayers can shoot up to your heaven from Singapore and come right down to Jerusalem. Lord, there's no distance with you. There's no even different time with you, Lord. You are the God who's closer than our breath. And so, Lord, we lift to you this cry for your people Israel, that you would pour out the spirit of grace and supplication on your people right now, Lord, in their homes, in their synagogues, as they're reading your word, Lord, as they're confessing their sins. Lord, would you pour out your spirit? Lord, could it be today? Could it be even today? So Lord, we lift to your people and we ask you, have mercy, Lord, according to the covenant you made with your servant David and according to your promises, Lord, throughout the scripture. Awaken your people, save your people, change their hearts, Lord, and give them a heart of flesh instead of a heart of stone. Take the veil away, Lord, that divides them from you and you from them. Give them eyes to see, Lord. Wake them out of the sleep. Shake off their dust. Break the chains, Lord. And let them wake up to you and your love for them, Lord God. We cry out to you from this place, Lord, all the way across the earth, wherever Jewish people are. In the name of Yeshua. Amen.
Acts chapter 3, 19 through 21, and also verse 25. This is part of a sermon. It's a public address that Peter gave, and we're getting right to the end of it, so we kind of drop in right toward the end. And we don't have a context here, but there is one, and you can look at it. He says here that there are four R's in English, doesn't work in another language, connected to the Jewish people accepting Yeshua. The first one, repent therefore, that's the first R, and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, so that the times of R, of refreshing, come. So the times of refreshing come from the presence of the Lord when the Jewish people turn to faith. Now there are times and seasons during the life of the body of Messiah when there will be refreshing coming, a little bit here, a little bit there. Various moves of that have created some controversy in the church, but there was a time in Toronto, there was a time in Bethel, refreshing. But what this refreshing is the last refreshing. And it says that refreshing will only happen when the Jewish people accept Yeshua. Then it says, and that he may send Jesus Christ, or Yeshua the Messiah, who has preached to you before. So we can call that the third R, return. The return of the Lord comes when the Jewish people accept him. We saw that in Matthew 23. Whom heaven must receive until the time of the restoration of all things, the fourth R, the restoration of all things. So these are small things, are they not? Small end time things, the return of the Lord, the times of refreshing, the restoration of all things. They're small. And it's all connected to verse 19, the repentance of the Jewish people. Doesn't this help us to understand why the enemy is targeting the Jews people so much? Because he knows their significance. And of course, there's a beautiful verse here in verse 25, you are sons of the prophets and of the covenant. So there's that prophetic calling reminded to us by the words of Peter as well. Okay, another passage, this might be interesting to some of you. It was interesting to me. A dear friend of mine, Mike Bickle, pointed it out to me. And I said, how does a man from Kansas City see this in the Bible here? But it's in the Bible, you see. Any one of us can see it. You just have to look. Micah 7. Micah chapter 7, verse 15. This says, in the day that God will bring the Jewish people back to all the lands that the United Nations says that they shouldn't come back to. So it mentions here Bashan and Carmel and Gilad. And those lands, of course, are across the border today. But he says he will eat, except Carmel. Carmel is what you eat when you want. You eat Carmels, you know, that's a different thing. But this is the mountain ridge called Carmel, and Bashan will be the Golan Heights, Gilad will be northern Jordan. So he says, I'm going to bring the Jewish people back prophetically to these areas here, as in days of old. And he says in verse 15, as in the days when you came out of the land of Egypt, I will show them marks. So, has anyone seen the movie The Ten Commandments? Have you seen it? How come they all speak with either British accents or American accents? But it says that you, if you stick around long enough, you're going to see